Great Lakes Now has reported before about PFAS, a family of industrial chemicals that's been found in wells and municipal water supplies serving millions of people. Now, we bring you the story of how some researchers are working to understand the health effects that PFAS and other emerging contaminants can cause in fish and maybe in people.
Bridget Baker is the deputy director of the Wayne State University Water Lab. She's taking a team of researchers out onto the Detroit River aboard a boat provided by the U.S. Fish and Wildlife Service. On the shoreline, heavy industry and a coal-burning electric plant.
We're really in close proximity to the water intake for the Great Lakes Water Authority, which is one of the main drinking water treatment plants for the Detroit metro area. So we like to get an idea of what's kind of taken into the water treatment plant.
They're gathering water samples to find out what chemicals have found their way into the river that provides drinking water to communities from Lake St. Clair to Lake Erie. 50 years ago, this waterway was one of the most polluted in the country. Industrial chemicals like PCBs, dioxins, and heavy metals that lurk mostly in the river bottom. There's been a lot of research into that, and the river has improved. But now attention has turned to a different breed of contaminants.
We're really more interested in what are called emerging contaminants, or contaminants that aren't largely regulated or thought of as contaminants. So for that reason, we don't really expect them to be in the sediment or at the lower levels.
Tracy Baker, Bridget's spouse, is Wayne State Water Lab's principal investigator and director.
There are a number of contaminants that most of us know about that are industrial and agricultural that have been in the environment for a while. But there's this new group of contaminants that we're looking at. We know are in the environment, but they haven't been studied a lot, and so we're not exactly sure what the health effects might be.
PFAS and other emerging contaminants pose health risks that aren't well understood, and this team is working to change that. Step one is figuring out what chemicals are actually in the environment.
So these four little bottles here will test for about 100 different chemicals.
And we know at least some of those chemicals can affect human health.
A lot of the chemicals that we're interested in looking at are endocrine-disrupting chemicals. So even at small amounts, they can act like hormones in our bodies. And PFAS is one of those chemicals.
PFAS, a family of many chemicals Great Lakes Now has told you about before, was used for decades in waterproofing agents, firefighting foam, Teflon pans, and even food containers. If it's waterproof, stainproof, or nonstick, it's probably got PFAS in it, and so do some of our region's rivers.
We traditionally sample at a meter depth, but again, because of the PFAS chemicals, the way their chemical structure is, they tend to stay at the surface of the water. So for these, we sample at both the surface and at a meter depth.
It's recently been in the news a lot, and so now, you know, a lot of us are concerned about it. It has been around since the 70s, so people knew it was there, but now it's kind of reemerged, and we're realizing that these chemicals are dubbed forever chemicals because they can stay in our body, and they can stay in our environment sometimes over 50 years.
Other chemicals found in waters like this might surprise you. Everything from cosmetics, sunscreen, and cleaning solutions to nicotine, prescription drugs, and cocaine. But are the combination of chemicals in the river water doing something to us? At the Great Lakes Water Authority's water treatment plant in Detroit, an army of zebrafish are helping us find out.
So these are the same fish that you would see in a pet store and in aquariums, but they are very hardy fish. And so because of that, and because the genome is sequenced and they develop very quickly, they've become a model for looking both at human health as well as environmental health.
These zebrafish live in untreated river water and act as canaries in the coal mine. If exposure to river water affects their health, it could affect ours too, and effects have been observed.
This is kind of our second run of this experiment, but on the first run, we did see that the fish that were raised in the Detroit River water, they were smaller in size. We saw an increased mortality, and it was pretty difficult to get them to lay eggs or fertilize eggs. So we're kind of repeating that at this point. It's the Detroit River that is bringing in the water. So these fish are basically being submersed in Detroit River water. Whereas at iBio, we are looking more specifically at individual chemicals that we know are in the Detroit River.
iBio is Wayne State University's Integrated Biosciences Center, where even more zebrafish are studied. Those chemicals that were found in the river samples? In the lab, zebrafish eggs are exposed to each of them in different doses.
We have different concentrations of PFAS. This is a mixture of PFOS and PFOA. We have one concentration at the EPA health advisory limit, which is 70 parts per trillion, and then concentrations above and below that.
Zebrafish develop very rapidly, so in 2 to 3 days, they're already free swimming. So we're able to look at a pretty large developmental time point in 5 days.
Over the next few days, the zebrafish are studied for abnormalities, and their behavior is analyzed.
We can then take the plate and track their behavior with this high-speed camera.
The very young zebrafish show changes immediately.
Then we can look and see different patterns of behavior and how they respond to those chemicals and what has changed neurologically with those fish. You start to see them swimming a little bit more sporadic. And that kind of gives you an idea that something is neurologically wrong with those. It isn't an exact answer of what it is, but it gives you a clearer or better direction to start looking at in terms of what's being modified in terms of neurotransmitters or patterns in the brain circuitry. Quite abrupt, and it's hard for even the camera to stabilize to be able to capture that.
We either see hyperactivity or we can see hypoactivity. That means that something didn't go right in the development of the brain.
The health effects seen in zebrafish are worrisome indicators of what emerging contaminants like PFAS could be doing to people.
We have seen gene expression changes that are related to cancer pathways as well as fertility and endocrine disrupting pathways in those fish. It is concerning that we are seeing these changes that could easily be linked to these chemicals causing disease, including cancer, as well as reproductive disease in humans.
For now, the research is focused on the Detroit River, but chemicals are entering the environment throughout the Great Lakes Basin.
One of our hopes is once we have some of this research under our belt here locally, is to take it to other cities in the Midwest, but also comparing it with non-urban and non-industrialized places throughout the Great Lakes.
Thanks for watching. For more on these stories and the Great Lakes in general, visit greatlakesnow.org. When you get there, you can follow us on social media or subscribe to our newsletter to get updates about our work. See you out on the lakes.